Welcome to another episode of Piano Tastings. My name's Rich Galassini.
And I'm Hugh Sung, and this is a show where we talk about what makes pianos beautiful and, frankly, unique. We're in a different situation today. We're not comparing two different pianos. We're actually going to be talking about one very special piano today. Tell us about it.
Well, this special piano is one of the Cunningham Composers.
Okay, what is a Cunningham Composer?
Good question. As the name implies, it allows the musician to record themselves at their piano, to mix that piano sound with acoustic instruments immediately right at the keyboard, to digitalize that sound into other instruments, to actually write what you're playing out on a grand staff, to then assign those parts of the grand staff to other instruments. We could send it to a wireless printer, email it nationwide. It's really cool.
Okay, now the technology cynic in me is going to be saying, like, well, you can do that with any standard keyboard. What makes the Cunningham Composer unique? I mean, really, you have a standard electronic keyboard, mm-hmm. you have a computer, you hook those things up. That's what people do all the time.
Yes.
What makes the Cunningham Composer unique?
Well, let me ask you a question.
All right.
You're a pianist.
Yes, I am.
Do you feel a little different inspiration when you're at a beautiful piano than you might when you're at a keyboard?
Well, you know, obviously, we've done several episodes where we've compared different acoustic pianos.
Right.
And as I've already demonstrated, different pianos, yes, absolutely. Even among acoustic pianos, different pianos, I will feel more inspired to play or to bring out different voicings
right.
depending on what I'm hearing back. So yes, that's true.
Now, I'm not saying that there aren't great keyboards out there. Yes, there are. But there are also great acoustic pianos. So we can find our favorite acoustic piano, sit down at it and do all of these things right at our acoustic piano.
Now, I will confess.
That's the advantage.
I will confess, because I do a lot of writing,
mm-hmm.
Digital, you know, I compose digitally using, you know, Sibelius, Finale, and all those standard notation programs. And if I'm just kind of writing notes one note at a time, that's one thing. I can use any digital keyboard. But if I had an interesting experience, actually. I was asked to actually compose jazz, and I don't play that much jazz, but I can improvise.
Mm-hmm.
I don't write it out. You have to improvise it. So the only way I could get the notes out was to improvise, basically, on the piano. And I tell you, I was improvising on a keyboard, and it was a terrible experience. It just felt mushy. I couldn't feel like I could get into the music. How much I wished I had my acoustic piano to just jam on and listen and feel the music. You just feel the music tactily on an acoustic instrument far differently than a digital one. If I had had that, I could have written so much better.
Right.
So that's an example, I think, case in point.
Well, that's really the key.
Yeah.
That's the key. So we can have our favorite acoustic piano outfitted with some tremendous, it's really taking 19th century technology and merging it with 21st century technology.
Well, listen, why don't we segue into, we're obviously not at the Cunningham Piano
yes.
Company. We're at a beautiful home here.
And we are about to enjoy a Peruvian feast.
Yes.
The family that we're with this evening is from Peru, and we have some tremendous, I hope we're going to take pictures. We'll get to see this too, but we're going to get to eat it.
And then we're going to come right back
That's
and
right.
give an interview with the brand new owner of this wonderful piano.
Yes.
And then I'll just do a quick overview as to what this instrument, this configuration can actually mm-hmm. do.
Carlos, thank you so much for the hospitality. We just had a wonderful Peruvian meal. I've never had chicken prepared the way I had this evening, never had pork prepared the way I had this evening. I've never had pisco. The wine, even the cola was different from anything that I've ever had before. Thank you so much. What great hospitality.
Our pleasure to have you home. This is your home, guys.
Thank you
We
so
are
much.
So honored to have you, Mr. Galassini, Rich.
Please call me Rich.
And Mr. Hugh Sung in our home. We're very happy and proud to have this opportunity to be here with you.
Wonderful. So you now have a customized Cunningham Composer in your home that will help your entire family experience music on another level. How is it that you came to us at Cunningham Piano and said, I want a composer? How did you find out about it?
Well, it was a long process. We're in Philadelphia for the last 5 years.
Yes.
And my son is taking piano lessons for the last almost 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
And we always dream of having a piano home. And we were searching and shopping around. And we eventually got a small piano, vertical piano.
Mm-hmm.
And he was playing, my son Carlitos was playing with that. And it was time to look for something better, bigger, and so forth. And as I said, I was shopping around and I found Cunningham Piano.
Wonderful.
And I give this a thought and then I start exploring your website and also got to know the website of Mr. Hugh Sung. And this work developed with the Cunningham Composer. And that really caught my attention. I had no knowledge of music, unfortunately, myself. But my kids, I think, have a lot of talent to or interest in music. So we went there. We stopped by. I still remember the day I went into the office in your store, and we met. And then we started exploring the possibility to buy a piano and then to make this special with the technology that is now available to take you to the next level. So we worked together on this. I appreciate your help and your technicians and your people in there. And Mr. Hugh was instrumental to work through the details to make this, I would call wonder, this new device kind of Cunningham piano plus the software technology that you offer.
Yes, and I should say that this is a custom Cunningham Composer, not quite like anything that we've done before. We had an awful lot of, we had a wish list that we put together what we'd like to be able to do. You can play analog instruments. You have a string player in the family.
Yeah.
You have singers in the family. Mm-hmm. You can play the piano and record them all and record them back and manipulate them and do all kinds of fantastic things. So this really is the meeting of the 19th century piano with 21st century technology.
Exactly.
In a wonderful way.
Is what it is, exactly.
Now, I'd like to put Hugh Sung to the test.
Absolutely.
To demonstrate it.
Absolutely, that would be great. Who better than him to
That's
do
right.
The idea behind the Cunningham Composer is a very simple one. We're combining an analog piano with the benefits of digital technology, basically creating a digital workstation right on an acoustic piano. A couple of really cool components. One of the coolest is this Mac touch screen. Wait a minute, Macs don't make touch screens. That's right, we came up with a really cool solution. There are custom drivers that you can find for certain Windows touchscreen monitors, and that's what we combined here. So here I've got the Mac OS X, and with the Mac OS X, of course, I can run things like GarageBand. So I've got GarageBand running. Let's start our song, the beginning over here, and I don't know, let's play something, and we've got a score here. What's really cool about this is the fact that I can start writing music with an acoustic piano. How cool is that? Stop. And look, my music comes out instantly. So GarageBand gives me great capabilities of not just recording instruments, but also writing music right off the bat. All right? And of course, I have these microphones, so if I wanted to sing along, I can record the audio. I can use different instrumentation, all these really cool things. So a touchscreen is nice and all, but really, do you need one? Well, let me show you a couple really cool things. One of the biggest benefits of a touchscreen is the fact, of course, that you could write on it. So for writing music digitally, this is great. You play, it'll automatically notate. But let's say you are working with regular sheet music. Take a look at this. Now I can be reading a little piece. Okay, so a little piece of PDF sheet music here. Let's say I need to make some markings as to a fingering. Let's go ahead and change the fingering here. I'm going to choose a red color. And let's go 1, 2, 3. Look at this. I can draw my markings right on the screen, just like a pen and paper. How cool is that? So I have the benefit of marking PDF files as well with certain programs. Again, that kind of takes advantage of the whole touchscreen system here. So I can draw on my music, I can compose, write, and work with all my things really paperlessly. Quite remarkable. Another really cool thing about working with this hybrid instrument is the fact that I can record audio directly. So you can either work with digital files or simply work it as an audio studio. Here's an open source program called Audacity. I've got two microphone inputs here, one here, a second one for another singer, and I can record audio. Take a look at this. I'm recording right now. So I'm not going to sing for you because I'm a terrible singer, but go. I don't know if you can hear this. So you can imagine you have all these tools right at your fingertips. You can write music, you can record music, you can experiment with different instrumentations, all underneath underneath your fingers. You can record songs as you're inspired. And I think the most interesting scenarios would be when you are improvising, when you're trying to come up with something, and you let your system run and record while you're having your session. Have you ever had that experience where you're noodling, suddenly something amazing comes in your mind, you play, you sing it, oh, I wish I wrote that down, yeah? Well, if you have a system like this and you leave it on record and get into the habit of recording yourself frequently, you'll never have those moments. You'll always be able to record everything, not just the way it sounds, but even the very notes that you've played. Think about that. So you can actually go back and see what you actually played, even if you're not even sure, even if you don't read music that well. You can have it notated, played back for you, print it out, share it with other people, record audio, make your own demo tracks. You start to see this becomes more than just a practice piano. This becomes a true, as the name implies, a true composer. You can really use this as a workstation for creating, being inspired to create new things. Really a neat idea. So check it out, the Cunningham Composer.